Good day, everyone, especially to our distinguished visible panelists. I am Vilma Pilinya, Principal 4 of Nike Integrated National High School. Together with me, my co-author, Wilbert A. Soriano, Master Teacher 1. We are here to present to you our research study entitled Teacher's Profile and Knowledge of Concepts on Classroom Assessment, Basis for Schools' Professional Development Plan. For our rationale, according to Brown 2019, assessment is inevitable among teachers. As stated in Learning Space 2021, still, some teachers perform just fairly on assessment. Based on LaSalle 2021, it is an integral part to understand students' learning and development. And based from DepEd Order Number 31, Series 2015, assessment should be improved and used to perform classroom practices and promote learning. This is why we have to conduct our study on teachers' profile and knowledge on assessment concepts.
Okay, so to continue with our research presentation, so here are our key literatures to support our study. So according to Beldwis and Dalby 2014, gaining knowledge about classroom assessment has high priority in educational research. At the same time, it will make us better know how the individual teacher carries out the collection of data of students' learning. And then second to this, we also have here another key literature which we extracted from the Department of Education Order Number 31, Series of 2020, which states the commitment of teachers to follow the principles which ground assessment, that it should be holistic and authentic in order to capture the essence most essential learning competencies. And lastly, we also considered DepEd Division Memo Order from the Province of Cavite Number 444, Series of 2022. So in line with the mantra of SDO Cavite's program AGAP, alamin ang gawain angkop sa pagtataya, which re-engineers assessment for 21st century learners in Cavite schools, are hereby instructed to integrate the structure of observed learning outcomes or SOLA taxonomy. Hence, the teacher's knowledge on such concepts assessment must be determined and be matched properly with due respect to their profiles. For our methodology, so our research design is mixed design, descriptive. So our samples and sampling technique use grade 7 to 12 teachers. We use probability sampling, non-random, purposive. And then for our research tool, we consider the use of survey questionnaire and informal interview. And then our data analysis is or are the following: frequency, percentage, and coding. So these are our findings. For research question number 1, what are the teacher's profile in terms of years in teaching and subjects handled and taught? So majority of the teachers were in 1 to 5 years of their teaching, and on the other hand, most teachers are handling science-related subjects. For our question number 2, what is the level of teacher's knowledge on assessment concepts? So the teachers exhibited high level of knowledge about the cognitive taxonomies. However, they are described to have low knowledge on concepts related to SOLO as framework of assessment. For our question number 3, what kind of teacher professional development program or support can be drawn from the study or from the finding? So, we found out that trainings on development programs focusing on SOLO framework must be done, as well as with capacity buildings that will enhance teachers' knowledge on similar frameworks of assessment. And for our conclusions, so we arrive on the following. So number 1, teachers' profiles such as years of teaching, specialization, and depth of knowledge on assessment concepts are factors to be considered in crafting quality assessments. Then teachers are not yet much familiar with concepts related to SOLO as a framework for creating test items. And then teachers must be placed accordingly to subjects they teach as per their specialization as much as possible. And then for our recommendations, so we have three recommendations here. Number one, it is recommended to also examine the affective and psychomotor skills of teachers in relation to crafting assessments. And then second, it is suggested that trainings and programs about assessment frameworks must be done in order to bridge the teachers know to what something new on classroom assessment. And then third, school administrators must consider teacher profile as they were displaced on their respective work assignments, especially to subjects they shall teach, since it connects a lot to their assessment knowledge and practices. And these are our references.